Now, alhamdulillah, whoever has this mechanism and he has developed within himself taqwa, always aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, always conscious of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will be protected by Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it will instill into him a certain fear not to disobey Him, either out of extreme love for Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a lover will never disobey the command of his beloved, or out of fear for his wrath or his punishment, the fear for the fire of Jahannam, the fear for the adab of the qabr. Irrespective, he will develop that mechanism which will help him to be a better human being. He will always walk towards that which is good and keep away from all those which is blameworthy, that will make him a better human being, a better Muslim. Sayyidina Mawla Ali Karramallahu ta'ala wajhahul kareem, when he defined taqwa as yal khawfu min al jalil wal amalu bit tanzil wal rida bil qalil wal isti'dadu li yawm ar rahil. Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu ta'ala alan babul wilaya states that taqwa essentially is fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fear of our creator, wal amalu bit tanzil, and always obeying the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, command which either be it Quran, wahi, revelation, or be it the sunnah, the sayings or the actions of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, wa rida bil qaleel, and to be content whatever little we have, always satisfied with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, desiring nothing but the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wal isti'dadu li yawm ar-rahil, and preparation for that journey towards the Akhirah, the journey of Mahshar, the journey of the day of Qiyamah, of reckoning. So this is the understanding of Taqwa. Now my respected viewers, that in order to have good akhlaq, we have to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how we deal with him, how we deal with his noble prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how we deal with humanity, how we deal with ourselves. So if we have this mechanism of taqwa, we will become people of zu akhlaq, people of good character, good attributes, good characteristics. Now, if we look at the Quran and the Sunnah of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in various verses some of the merits, some of the importance of taqwa. As I have said, taqwa is discussed more than 151 times in the Quran itself. Such is the importance of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, only those who have taqwa, those that are called muttaqoon, are guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهُ هُدَى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. That is the book that is concerned, which there is no doubt about it. هُدَى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. It is a guidance for those who possess taqwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مُحْسِنُونَ. Allah's closeness, Allah's shelter, Allah's qurb is of those people who develop taqwa within themselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will become close to them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, build your foundation, whatever you build, be it your amal, your actions, your life, build it on the foundation of taqwa, it will last, it is better. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَمَنْ أَسَّسَ بُنْيَانَهُ عَلَى تَقْوَى مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانٍ خَيْرٌ أَمَّنْ أَسَّسَ بُنْيَانَهُ عَلَى شَفَا جُرُفٍ هَارٍ فَانْحَارَ بِهِ فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمَ اللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do you think that whoever has built his foundation on taqwa and for the pleasure of Allah, is that foundation better? Or that foundation which is built on the undermined sand cliff, which we may crumble to pieces, and verily it will crumble to pieces, leading directly into the fire of Jahannam. So which is better, which foundation? That foundation that is strong, built on the foundation of piety, taqwa, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or that foundation which is built on a sand cliff, undermined, that is about to crumble. So we need to understand how we want to live our life and build a house of amal, good deeds, a house of obedience, a house of character, that we need to build it on good foundation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even goes on further. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you develop taqwa and you work towards it, Allah ta'ala says, it will become a criteria for you to distinguish what is good and what is evil, what is good and what is bad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu in tattaqullah yaj'al lakum furqana. O you who believe, if you become conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, aware of Him at all times, He will develop within yourself a furqan, a criteria, so you may distinguish whatever is good, whatever is wrong, what hurts people, what pleases people, what hurts Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ يُسْرًا. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam quotes the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, develop that mechanism of taqwa and I will make your life easy for you. So some of these are the merits of the virtues of developing taqwa. Allah's closeness, Allah comes close to us. We as His slaves, His servants, desire that nearness to Him. And if we develop that awareness of Him, He will become close to us. He will become our protector. He will become our refuge. He will become our shelter, our hope. And our assistance, His assistance will be on us in this dunya, whatever we do in our business, in our homes, in our society, in our deen, in our dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always assist us. That is why Allah ta'ala says, Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. The most honorable amongst you are those that have taqwa, always aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we won't disobey Him, because we claim to love Allah, but we're not aware of Him. As the poet says, تَعْصِ الْإِلَهَ وَعَنْتَ تُذْهِرُ حُبَّهُ هَذَا لِعُمْرِ فِي الْقِيَاسِ بَدِيعُ لَوْ كَانَ حُبُّكَ صَادِقًا لَأَطَعْتَهُ إِنَّ الْمُحِبَّ لِمَنْ يُحِبُّ مُطِيعُ. He says, you'll disobey your creator, yet your claim to love Him. This in all my life is the greatest innovation that exists. For indeed, if your love was sincere and true, you will have obeyed Him. For a lover never disobeys the command of his beloved. We claim to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but the true lovers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are those that are always aware of Him, conscious of Him. Like Rabia Basriya al-Adawiyya radiyallahu ta'ala anha, used to sit on top of a house in the middle of the night after attending to the work of her master, exhausted, but used to sacrifice her sleep for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, always aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, communicating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why Allah ta'ala brought her close to Him, and she developed a nearness to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are people of Ahlullah. That is why when you see them, you are reminded of Allah. الَّذِينَ هُمْ إِذَا رُعُوا ذُكِرَ اللَّهِ. Those people that are seen, people are reminded of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that are attracted towards them. But now, who are these Ahlullah? The people of character, the people of akhlaq, that define them as true representation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's word on this earth. Just to give an example, some of the qualities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ali Imran, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاهِ وَالضَّرَّاهِ وَالْكَاذِمِينَ وَالْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah Ta'ala says, the first quality is الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاهِ وَالضَّرَّاهِ. Those that spend in the path of Allah in easy times and in difficult times. Now yunfiqun does not only mean the spending of one's wealth, it means the spending of one's time, one's strength, one's assistance, one person's support to help another human being, to help another person that is in difficulty. Whether a person can do it, whether he's at ease, or whether he's in, also when he's in difficulties, but despite being in difficulties, he still comes to the assistance of a fellow human being. That is why Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, وَلِيَنْ أَمْشِي مَهَا أَخٍ فِي حَاجَةٍ حَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ أَنْ أَعْتَقِفَ فِي هَذَا الْمَسْجِدِ. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, to walk with my brother, to help him, assist him, and to take care of him is more beloved to me than spending 1 month of i'tiqaf, seclusion, in this masjid of mine in Medina al-Munawwara. So the first quality is that you have to be able to spend in the path of Allah, not only on your wealth, but on your time, your support, and your strength, and so on. Then Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ وَالْغَيْزِ, that a person must be able to swallow his anger. That Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, لَيْسَ الشَّدِيدُ بِالسُّرْعَةِ وَإِنَّمَا الشَّدِيدَ الَّذِي يَمْلِكْ نَفْسَهُ إِنْدَ الْغَضَبِ. A strong person is not he who is able to overcome another due to his physical strength, but a true strong person is he who can control himself in a state of anger, swallow his anger. And even no matter what a person may do for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam says, swallow that anger and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you abundantly. Then you have another quality. The Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam says, wal'afina anin nas, ready to pardon people, forgive them, overlook their difficulties, overlook the difficulties, overlook the transgressions, overlook the shortcomings, overlook the transgression upon yourself. You must be able to forgive, have a gentle heart, a heart that is merciful, a heart that is compassionate. That is why I look at the example of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an, when his daughter Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, Ummul Mu'mineen, the mother of the believers and the beloved wife of Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when she was accused of an ugly crime, and Surah An-Nur talks about it, and the person to have insinuated or brought up this rumor that smeared the character of Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha was a person that was given a stipend, a allowance by Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, being a father, he must have got upset, he must have got angry that this person who I am helping is insulting or accusing my beloved daughter, but of a heinous crime. He could have stopped that allowance. He could have came to this person and spoke to him with anger. But Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an still continued to give this man his allowance, help this man in difficulty, and did not go and reprimand him or insult him or hit him or beat him up, simply because he knew Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's word in the Holy Quran, وَلْيَعْفُ وَلْيَسْفَهُ, and pardon and forgive one another, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may forgive you. He saw goodness, and inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer, and he will clear my daughter's name, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will also forgive this person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may guide him. These are the qualities of Ahlullah, the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, simply because they had that mechanism of taqwa, always aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was not a moment in time that they were not aware of him. Their existence on this earth was due, every breath they took was because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they was aware of it. So alhamdulillah, this is the first characteristic that we need to develop within ourselves. Taqwa, always be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as the show goes on, inshallah, we will give you certain ways on how to develop it, how to attain it, and how to become a muttaqi, a person that is pious, always aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the next show, inshallah, as we discuss the various other attributes of good character, we will discuss mechanisms of way how to, by practicing it and being repetitive of those qualities, it will become a habit and adha and natural fitra within ourselves, inshallah. We thank you, and inshallah, the viewers of Akhlaq, what defines a Muslim, inshallah, we hope that you come and join us on our next episode. إن شاء الله وما علينا إلا البلاغ مع السلامة